We are creating a simple budget here, and we're going to display our planned expenses versus our actual expenses. And this is for January. I've renamed my sheet here January. And so we have our income here, and let's say we're taking home $4,000 a month. And then let's go down the list, okay? Let's say our mortgage is $1,500 and our power is $150 and the gas is $80 and the food we plan to spend $600 and the car payment is $350 and we normally spend $300 a month on entertainment. Now, to calculate your savings, what you're going to do is you're going to subtract all of these expenses from your total income or your take-home income. So let's go do a little formula in here. And so we'll go equals, and we'll select our income. And then we're going to minus or subtract the total of all of these expenses. So let's put a bracket in here, and let's go sum. And let's put another bracket, and then let's select all these, and then we're going to close that bracket, and we're going to close the other bracket, and we're going to press enter. And so if everything works out the way it's planned, we'll have $1,020 that we're going to put in our savings account every month. But let's see what our actual looks like compared to our planned. So the mortgage payment is still the same, but the power was only $120 this month. And the gas was only $60. But our food budget, we went a little overboard. It was $675. Our car payment is still $350. That's the same. Now our entertainment, we went a little out on the board and we spent $500 on our entertainment. So now let's calculate. Let's calculate the total savings we have actually. So once again, we go equals, and then we're going to select our income, and we're going to go minus, and then we'll put an opening bracket, and we'll go sum, and then we'll go this opening bracket again, and we're going to select our expenses, and we're going to close that bracket and close the other bracket. And actually, we're only going to put in $795 in our savings this month. So let's put a graph on this. So let's select the values that we have. Let's go to insert on the menu bar, and let's go let them recommend a graph that we're going to have. Oh, this one looks pretty good. So let's select this one, and we're going to say okay. So now, there we have a graph of our planned versus our actual expenses. So what we can do is double click here and change it to expenses. Perfect. Okay, so now we've got January done. So we'd like to do this for February, March, April, May, that type of thing. So let's go to sheet 2, and we're going to double click on sheet 2, and we're going to rename it February. And press enter. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go back and we're going to select all of sheet 1. Let's just close this so we can see everything. And so what we're going to do is go to this box in between the A and the 1 right here, and we're going to go control C, and then we're going to go press enter. And here you have everything brought forward for you. So let's just play around a little bit to fix up the graph. Now, so these are January expenses, so let's put in some February expenses. The plan is all the same. So your power this month was $170, and your gas was $75. And your food was $600, and your car payment is always the same, and your entertainment, you only spent $300 this month. So you had a savings of $1,050. But if you notice, this graph doesn't reflect this. So what we're going to do is we're going to right click on our graph and we're going to go select data. Okay, so if you look at the top here, it says January. So let's take that January out here and let's put in February. And say okay. And so now you have a graph that reflects your February expenses. So you could continue doing this for the rest of the year to track how things are going. So that's a pretty simple budget that you can copy for each month. Please subscribe. I have videos once a week.